That's the normal pressure. Let's boost it. Okay, with this switch. It's filling up really fast. So guys, today in this video I'm going to convert it into a short, compact and portable battery operated DC pump. Now guys, the first thing that you will notice is the exceptionally large shaft. So to make it compact, I will have to cut it a little bit. Now guys, this what you see is a heavy duty ABS plastic case in which I am planning on installing the 12 volts UPS battery, the 12 volts DC motor and the pump itself. Now guys, this is an unwanted plastic projection that is getting in the way of pump insertion. So guys, I'm going to cut it off with the help of my drill press. I'm going to bore an even bigger hole than this one so that the extra part cuts off automatically. So guys, here as you can see that I have placed the pump like this with the strip and it is rigid and strong and the shaft is also moving pretty good. Now comes the part of connecting the DC motor to the shaft, and I have already cared about the alignment. You can see there are some cushioning provided to bring the shaft to the height of the motor slot. Okay, you see it's almost identical. But before connecting the motor to the pump itself, I will have to take care for the motor itself, because there is a possibility that the water leaks from the pump with time and it rusts the clutch system or anything. So I have to take care about that problem if it arrives in the future. So starting with this is this thick foam. Okay, and size is going to be this much, and I will have to place it like this.
After doing all that comes the part of placing this PVC sheet on this battery, because you see these slots. When the battery charges, bubbles come out from the water or the dilute sulfuric acid inside, which pushes the cap upwards, and there is some leakage of the acid. So to prevent that, I will be placing this PVC sheet. It will allow air to escape but also prevent the caps from flying out like a rocket. Now guys, after completing the process of taping of the battery for protection from the acid leaking, comes the part of keeping the motor in place with the help of aluminium strip sheet. So let's give it a spin and see how it is working. Okay. See, pretty good. So guys, here as you can see that I have taken one wire from the DC motor, the black one, and I have connected it to the switch over here. Okay, and the second wire is not connected anywhere except to this clip, which will be connected directly to the 12 volt 7Ah battery. Okay. Now there is one more terminal left on the switch, and to this terminal I will connect this yellow wire, which will again be connected from this side to the 7Ah battery. So guys, after doing all this wiring, it's finally time to connect the battery. Okay, so this is the battery. So yes, the battery has also been placed. Now guys, this yellow wire, I will connect it to the negative terminal first. Okay, that's the negative terminal. Now comes the positive wire, the only left out wire. Yeah, so let's connect this one too. Okay, yeah, so this one is also connected. Now let's turn on the switch. You see, it's working. This, what you see guys, is a USB port which I'm going to use to charge this 12 volts battery, although this port is used usually for 5 volts as you have seen in mobile charging systems and chargers.
Here, as you can see, I have also placed hot glue so that it fixes strongly and rigidly. And this is the USB cable, and it is going to be something like this. And this red LED is going to indicate the starting of charging of the battery when I connect the USB cable over here.
Now guys, this is 1 kilo ohm resistor which I'm going to connect with this LED in series to limit the current flow.
This black wire from the USB port is going to be connected to this resistor, okay?
You see, it is glowing.
So to prevent that, I'm going to use this 6 amperes diode, okay? And this is the positive side of the diode which will be connected to the LED over here, and the negative to this white terminal. Okay, you see, now the light bulb is not glowing and that's done. So diode has been connected, charging cable has been connected, everything done. Now comes the testing part and also the back cover. So guys, here as you can see that the charging system at the pump, the motor, as well as the battery all have been placed, and this is the main switch. Okay, and this red LED, you see, it was going to indicate when the charger is connected to this setup. Let's turn it on and see how it works. See, it's working.
Well guys, this plastic piece, you see, this is going to be the cover of the water pump. And here, as you can see, I have made a mark where I'm going to drill a hole, and this part was a little cracked, so I've used Fevikwik to fix it again. So it's finally time to cover the head.
Here, as you can see guys, I've placed 7 screws, this, then 2 on this side, and then again 2 on this side. Together 7 screws holding the 2 cases strongly. This is the cover, and a lower piece is the one holding the battery, motor and the pump, along with all the remaining circuitry. And guys, now comes the part of placing the handle. You can see that I have given a curve over here that is going to be placed like this. Let's drill a hole over here for placing a bolt. Thank you.
So guys, this one that you see is the hole that I bored, and this piece I have made the marking at the back, and I have to cut off this piece from here so that it can be placed here like this. Now guys, this what you see is a 15 volts 3 amperes laptop charger, as I have already showed you in many of my previous videos. I have cut off its main cable and connected this USB cable that I showed you at the beginning of this water pump video. Now when I'm going to connect this over here, you have seen the red LED. So this is going to indicate if it has started charging or not. And as you can see that the LED has started glowing, indicating that the charging part has started. So leave it for a few hours, and also the charging is under protection. I'm using a 15 volts charger, but I've connected a diode in series. So the diode is going to cut off the 15 volts to around 14.3 volts, which is ideally needed for charging the 12 volts UPS battery. Here, as you can see, this is the pressure I'm getting from the tap water. You see, slow pressure. So this is the extension pipe that goes to the booster pump, and here this actual pipe connects to this. That's the normal pressure. Let's boost it. Okay, with this switch. It's filling up really fast. Okay, so this is the normal pressure that we get. Now let's boost it.